I don't know anything about structures. I don't know anything about airplanes, really. I don't know about how these doors fit into frames. So that's all not my specialism. I do know the people who are involved in this whole project. I do have a verse from the Bible that I would like to share with you. Verse. It's from Jeremiah 29, verse 11. For I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. They are plans for good and not for disaster, to give you a future and a hope. The context that this verse is written in is when the Jews were in exile. They were in Babylon and they were not in a good place. They were taken away from their home country. They were they were refugees really. And Jeremiah was prophesying, and he was in Jerusalem still, but all these people that he was talking to were in a very, very difficult place. So often this verse is being used as, well, almost as a prosperity teaching verse, I would say. But God, I think, doesn't promise us easy times when we are looking at God giving us hope and a future. And good doesn't always mean the good that we think is good. So, yeah, we are built on a firm foundation, I hope. I don't know, again, I don't know anything about that. But there's also storms that we have to go through. So there's good times, there's bad times. And we have to go through this, and it builds us up, and it sometimes really hurts, and sometimes it's very painful. And when things seem to be going wrong, or when things are not done the way you think it has to be done, or when things are slow, or when there's still so much that we need to do to make this kind of completely finished. But we need to build our house on the rock, and even though the storms may come and go, God wants to give us a future and a hope, and I just pray that this hangar is going to be such a big blessing for so many people who are in despair, who don't have hope at the moment, and who just need to hear and to get this good news that we have. That's all I want.
Anyway, besides it, the amount of effort that has been put into setting this all up, it's just wonderful, and I do think coming out of Love International, Steve and your team, Case and your team, and all others who have been part of this setup, thank you very, very much. We don't take it for granted. We don't take it as something that you just do on the sideline. It has been an enormous amount of investment of your time, your energy, the vision that was needed for it, but also to make it practically work is enormous. And also the bites of all of them who have been there listening to their husbands coming home being tired, disappointed, maybe even frustrated. Again, thank you all very, very much for making this all work so wonderfully. It's great to see Gajansi the way it has been developing, as some of you already have been saying. Yeah, I've been here before. I still remember the very first walk we had along the runway up and down just to pray that God will give us wisdom in how to develop the place, how to make this a place that God is able to use. And now if you look back 10 years later, you do see God's blessing over it. Although sometimes when you're in the middle of setting up a hangar, you wonder why and how.
I'm just going to look this way and say a big thank you to the donors as well, because although we don't know who you are individually, we're well aware of many countries who have donated very generously to this wonderful project, from the UK, the Netherlands, I know Sweden as well, and there's possibly other countries as well. And we want to thank you for your generosity in making all this happen, so thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Tack så mycket. Ik wil jullie ontzettend bedanken voor jullie bijdrage aan deze aanvraag.
Dank u.
Van harte bedankt voor alle bijdrage aan deze prachtige aanvraag.